From DocuSign, Go Live Part 2, Getting Ready. In this video, I'll discuss the prerequisites for the Go Live process, including the API polling rules and related issues. First, your application needs to be ready to be tested, at least beta status. Your application works, but may still have some known issues. Does not break the DocuSign polling rules. I'll cover the rules during this video. Does not cause any API errors. To pass Go Live, your application needs to generate 20 test API calls without API errors, either automatically or manually. Your application must have its own integration key and use OAuth to obtain access tokens. SOAP apps are the exception. They do not use OAuth. Note that your application cannot use the DevCenter's access token generator during the Go Live process nor in production. Second, you'll need a DocuSign production account for managing the integration key. The account can also be used for sending and managing DocuSign envelopes. You can use your main DocuSign account as the IK management account. A separate account is not needed. After Go Live, your production integration key can be used by any user on any production account with API access anywhere in the world. Only certain account plans can be used for the DocuSign account used to manage your integration key. Check the documentation in the Go Live section of the Developer Center for the list of accepted account types. ISVs, independent software vendors, in the DocuSign Partner Program can request a free integration key management account. Third, you'll need specific permissions on the DocuSign systems. You'll need to be a system administrator for your Integration Keys Developer Sandbox account to submit the integration key for review. You, or someone whom you know, needs to be a system administrator for the production account that will manage the integration key. If you're not a system administrator for the production account, you can have an admin briefly log into the production account via your workstation or using screen share when needed by the Go Live process. Or the production account's administrator can temporarily make you an administrator for the account. Now we'll discuss the specific API issues that your application must fulfill to pass Go Live. The first is a 20 API call requirement. The calls need to be made within a single 24-hour period. The three API methods listed on the slide do not count towards the 20-call minimum. You only need to make 20 API calls, not 20 application transactions. If each transaction via your application includes more than one API call, you can make fewer transactions to reach the 20 API call requirement. Your application can make the test calls automatically or manually. Each of the calls must complete successfully. The API calls don't need to return results to your application, but there must not be any API errors. An API call is successful if it returns a status code in the 200 to 299 range. You can make additional test calls before the 20 calls, and those test calls can have errors. You can only make successful calls after the API calls that will be reviewed. DocuSign encourages developers to use the Connect webhook system to receive envelope status change notifications from DocuSign. The alternative of your application pulling DocuSign for status changes is available to your application, but only in accordance with the polling rules. In general, your application can poll for a specific envelope status once every 15 minutes or less frequently. Rule number one, you can call the same API method, for example, envelopes get, more than once in a 15-minute period, only if each call is for a different envelope ID. Rule number two, for a unique envelope resource, you can make a get call, then a put call to update the envelope, then a get call. There can be other calls in between. Rule number three is not allowed. It's polling. You can't call the same get API method twice or more in a 15-minute period for a specific envelope. The only exception is rule two above. This rule applies to any get call. For example, listing the documents in a specific envelope is only allowed once every 15 minutes. There are special rules for the two API methods that enable you to get status for a list of envelope IDs with one call. Rule 4 is that it is permitted to make multiple calls within a 15-minute period if non-overlapping results are requested. For example, different sets of from date and to date parameters or different envelope IDs. However, the current caveat to Rule 4 is that issue number DCM3308 may cause your go-live test to not pass, since the system may mistakenly think that you are polling via the API method. If you're sure that you're only requesting non-overlapping results, you can request a manual review of your go-live test results in this case. However, this will delay your overall go-live process. A better solution is to only make the call once every 15 minutes. Rule 5 is the polling situation. You can't call these API methods with the same envelope ID or overlapping result requests more often than once every 15 minutes. That's it. Watch the next video for a full demonstration of the Go Live process. Please subscribe to the DocuSign for Developers channel by clicking the subscribe button. And please check the bell notification icon too. That way you'll be notified when we release new videos. Thank you very much.